Hi everyone, we are here today to record a new episode of our show Ads and Grants. My name is Vasily Gamov, I am Chief Marketing Officer at richads.com. And today I am joined by Raúl Cruz Arnelas, Director of Masters and Cash, a Mediablue holding. Many of you know Masters and Cash, but very few people know Raúl. For many years, he was a guy from the shadows that managed great projects and did it like a lot for the industry. And now we are very pleased to be the first who is going to interview Raúl. In this episode, we'll discuss the latest dating trends, how to create a new direct dating offer, and what is the reason why Mediablue decided to launch a new platform to build new products for affiliates. We also will talk about the business processes, team, and profits. Stay tuned. Okay, and we're going to start with the part with a discussion about Raúl, about his experience. Raúl, could you tell us about your experience more? Because from your LinkedIn, we know that you have huge experience in the market. What companies gave you the most for your professional growth?
First of all, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be in this channel. I'm a huge fan. So when you told me, hey, let's do it. Wow. For me, it's a great opportunity to talk with your audience. So thank you so much. Secondly, in terms of your question, I had the opportunity to work for some of the best companies in the digital advertising market during the last 15 years. So it's difficult to pick one experience.
So I will pick four. For example, launch native ads in Spain with Outbrain, where I could learn a lot about start a business in our industry from scratch. It was an incredible experience because Outbrain in Spain, or native ads in Spain, it was not there. And launching a new way of achieving your marketing goals, attacking your users, it was amazing. It was pretty tough and I learned a lot. Also enjoyed the biggest growth that I could ever see in Mobusi, thanks to a great team, great strategy, and the best timing, built and learned my own team in Clickdealer Spain as well, and actually in Mastering Cars, where I could work every day with some of the best in our industry. In the dating industry. So there's a lot of experience during a lot of time, but at the end, I feel honored that I've had the opportunity to work with some of the best companies and best teammates in the market.
It looks like you have enormous and various experience. That's very nice.
Yeah, for now, an old guy, yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. Now you work with the dating vertical in Masters and Cash. And was it something new for you, or you also was familiar with this vertical before?
It's not 100% new for me. In Mobusi, I had the opportunity to work with many dating advertisers with subscription models. Mobusi, at that time, it was one of the biggest European mobile ad networks in Europe. We work mainly with mobile subscription model advertisers and mobile advertisers that needed big volumes of subscriptions or installations for their apps.
In Clickdealer, for example, I had the opportunity to work with some of them again and also work with other verticals like sweepstakes, gambling, lead gen, Nutra, etc. So in Mastering Cash, I've learned everything about the token-based model.
During these 15 years, I've learned some of the details of the business from many angles, from sales to affiliation, management, leadership, and now from the advertiser angle. Let's say that I've joined the dark side of the force.
Yeah, nice. And why did you accept this offer from Masters and Cash? Was it clear to you how your knowledge can be useful there? What is like the main reason for that?
It was easy. Working for great professionals like Ilse Bolina or Stefan Mohbauer, it's a privilege for me. I couldn't say no to this opportunity. On the other hand, I wanted to keep learning about the dating industry. Master in Cash is one of the main brands in this segment, and for me, it's an honor to work with them. I've been creating and managing teams during more than 20 years, and with them, we've improved the figures drastically in all the projects. So this is exactly what Master in Cash needed, and this is why I'm here today.
Yeah, I know a little bit about your team, and it's really great. And unfortunately, I don't know personally Ilse, but I have heard about her huge experience in the building affiliate marketing teams in different fields. And also, I met Stefan in Bucharest in Romania this spring, and he was after that one of our guests on our channel. By the way, dear viewers, you can check his speech in the video How to Build an Affiliate Network or Program. We will add the link in the description. So you have a great team, and let's switch to another part. For more than 10 years, you worked at Masters in Cash and Mediablue, and can you tell us more about these companies and your role there?
I'm the director of Master in Cash, that is the affiliation division of Mediablue, one of the first and main dating advertisers in the market.
Mediablue created in-house offers since 2010. My team manages a big, huge portfolio of affiliates that delivers different types of traffic every day to Mediablue's portfolio of dating products. So Master in Cash is the affiliate part of the business. Mediablue is the dating advertiser.
No, nice. And could you tell us more about Mediablue and their direct offers for adult dating? What is it exactly?
Sure. We manage adult dating offers in 20 European unions, European EOs, plus Australia. We manage generic adult dating offers, but also MILF, BDSM, and CMIL offers. We started with generic sex dates offers, and afterwards we added more and more niches. And this is just the beginning, because we are preparing more and more different niches just to be sure that we can extend the portfolio of products to attend their needs of our customers everywhere.
Yeah, it looks like a market expansion, yeah? And can you tell more, a little bit more about the offers? What is it exactly? Like what niches?
Today we can separate it in four different groups. BDSM includes bondage, dominance, and submission. CML, it's about transgender. MILF is about attractive old woman, everybody knows it. And generic is just sex dating.
Yeah. Looks like adults are inspired with your products, I suppose. And yeah. You have mentioned that you work with a token-based model from the very beginning. What does it mean and how does it work?
The token-based model is different from the subscription one, even if both belong to the same vertical. Our customers pay for a number of messages that they want to spend on our product to talk with people. We offer those messages in different bundles in order to allow our users to purchase the one that fits their budget better. Depending on the geo, the price per message, and in consequence, the price of each bundle is completely different. Currently, we work with our affiliates on a DOI basis, double opt-in, per lead, and on rev share as well.
And what is the price range here?
The price range per message for users starts from €1 to €3. And it depends on how large it's the payment of the user for each bundle, but also it depends on the geo, as I mentioned before.
Yeah, okay. And let's add some words about your internal media buying team. Do your media buyers run your own offers?
Yeah, far from the affiliation team that is the biggest in terms of traffic sources, we manage two different media buying areas in the team. One focused on Google traffic and the other on media buying on ad networks and certain flat buys as well. Testing and promoting our own offers internally first bring us the chance to test what is performing better and what is not, and fix it or improve it our portfolio every day. Thanks of our data team, we monitor each offer on a daily basis to allow us to keep the best performance. So you can imagine that every day we analyze proper data and we improve and make some fixes and tweaks just to be sure that we can keep the best performing for our partners.
Okay, now we have like a general view on your platform. And let's talk a little bit about your current project. Some days ago in personal talk, you mentioned that you're preparing a great update of your platform. What is the aim, the main goal of these updates, and what are you going to change and why?
As I mentioned before, Mediablue was one of the first advertisers in the adult dating vertical. And from the beginning, we developed a platform in-house. It was a long time ago.
So during all these years, the industry has changed and it challenges us with new features that will help our partners and us to make more money. We decided to build a new platform that will bring us the opportunity to launch new super easy, great performing offers with all the experience that we have today.
The first one will be launching our products in North America. The first country will be Canada. It's a great market that we are so excited, where some of our partners are making good figures, and it will be a good start in an expansion plan.
Yeah, and what markets and researches did you do before deciding to join North American market?
We built a go-to-market strategy that took months to work on it. We did a huge research about the Canadian market, for example, about the volumes, the payouts, competitors, customers, margin, et cetera, it's tons and tons of data there. So we've taken all this data to build our process to land in Canada. This process will help us to replicate in other new geos where we want to go. We analyze the potential of affiliates, competition analysis, internal strategy, landers and creatives of all the competitors on each market, list of all programs covering that geo, the small players, the biggest ones, size of the market, speed to market, payouts and rates. As you can see, I'm just covering just the top of the iceberg. It's tons and tons of data. So with all of this data, we evaluate market data through KPI comparison, and then we build our creative strategy for our new products in that geo.
Yeah, as soon as there is quite a huge population in North America, like 500 million people in average, and average salaries are high, I suppose you have really enormous potential in this market. So good choice. I wish you good luck with this beginning. And let's switch to metrics. What are the main metrics and numbers you were taking into account by choosing Canada market as a new market for you?
We consider a long list, many, many KPIs, but the main ones will be size of the market, average profit per visitor, cost per acquisition, product affinity, and customer lifetime value. At the end, everything is related with the last one, the customer lifetime value. At the end, this is where we build a KPI tree internally. In terms of measure, it's step of the way of the customer lifetime value of the user. So we usually take advantage of each step and how much we can take advantage, and we make it more and more profitable. Then we can bring more or better payouts for our partners. So at the end, this is the main key for us, the main KPI.
Yeah, it's really crucial to work on lifetime value because it's the heart of your business.
That's
what
it.
What new features will the new platform have?
Well, a lot. The list is endless. With the new platform, we will have the chance to offer, for example, new payment models like CPS, SOI, etc. New flows to the offers, have the chance to bring new business models like subscription models, for example. Today, as I mentioned, we are working on token-based model. Why not expand it to the subscription model as well as our competitors or some of our competitors are doing, right? So with the new platform, we will have the chance to do that or speed up the optimization processes to bring better results faster to our partners.
Yeah, and also in the private talk, you mentioned that you're switching from the old platform to a new one because of some legacy issues, because you want to make it more flexible. So What technologies do you use for building this new platform, like Ruby, JavaScript, whatever? What do you use exactly? Could you give some insight?
Yeah, let me tell you that it's difficult for me to bring you all the details because it's internal stuff. But I can inform you that our new platform uses a microservice architecture in the cloud with optimal reliability and scalability as well.
Okay, sounds fair enough. And you have mentioned that you are going to add the CPS model and SOI despite DOI model. Tell us more about this decision, please. Why did you choose it?
Mastering Cas is an advertiser that has a very close relationship with our partners. We don't treat them like numbers. We have personal relationship with them, with each of them, and we know quite well what they need every day to make more money with us. The payment model sometimes is the scenario to choose where our affiliates feel more comfortable. It's not better or worse, it's just that it's better for them. So for us, it's pretty important. In a long-term relationship, these things make the difference, and we want them to feel more and more comfortable. Because at the end, we were working for a long, long time in this market, and we want to at least to do the same to the next 20, 40 years.
Yeah, Stefan also mentioned that like affiliate is also the core, the heart of your business, and you put a high attention to them. And what goals are you going and do you want to reach with these new updates?
Our main goal is to keep improving our standards of quality to offer to the market the best performance and the better products to increase the earnings of our partners. These new updates combined with the new data strategy will bring us the chance to get the best possible profit. If we talk about numbers, we think we can generate a plus 40% revenue boost during the next couple of years.
Sounds good enough. And I should ask it in the very beginning, but is your business profitable and how much did it take to make it profitable from scratch?
It's a good question. Yes, it's a profitable business for sure. For us, it took a short period of time to start making good figures because we were one of the first dating of the advertisers in the market and we could take advantage of many deals that were not developed by any competitor. You can imagine that in some years, it was an open field. Afterwards, many advertisers started competing with us in all those years. Today, all years are competitive, but in some, we have a really big edge like Denmark, Hungary, Greece, or Czech Republic as well.
Oh, nice. And let's talk a little bit about trends and how they affect your business. What dating trends in particular do you see? How do they affect your business? And what are like the most promising for you?
Niches are one of the most important trends that we can cover today. For example, as I mentioned before, we have BDCM and CMO offers in some geos. But this month, we will launch these products in all of our geos. So as I mentioned, 20 geos in Europe plus Australia. So in all of them, we will cover because they are performing great. And our partners are requesting us for those offers. So I will say that Mastering Cash has the biggest portfolio of fully localized CMO dating offers in the world right now.
And how do Masters in Cash use these trends?
Exactly. Our new business department updates each quarter our market research that brings us the info to modify our strategy on each market. We also have other sources that we consider crucial or affiliates. They inform us every day about the lenders, offers, and geos that perform better each week. We also have another source of info, our internal media buying team, as I described before. The last source is our data team. They track each KPI on the lifetime value of each customer. With all of this information, we update our strategy each quarter. In dating, the most important part is the engagement with your service, the user with your service. There's many ways to keep high standards on this. Pop-up messages, push notifications over browser for marketing messages, a timeline about everything happening, et cetera, et cetera. There's many, many ways. In the platform, go ahead, please.
Yeah. And what about the platform? How do you use it there?
In the platform, the improvement of the profiles to make them more attractive to the users. There are just examples of how much you can do to increase the engagement. You need to be creative in all the areas of your product and take advantage of any of them. For example, you can customize your captcha using pictures of people that you could find in the product. So even if this is a process that it's pretty boring for all of us, let's be honest, you can change it to something more attractive. So if you are creative, at the end, you can improve your engagement a lot. And this is the main key, because on dating advertising, engagement and conversations, it's one.
Yeah, like you need to always to use different ads, different trends, and not to be afraid of doing mistakes, test, and you will be in profit zone for sure.
That's it.
And can you tell us more about how Masters in Cash create direct offers? Do you start with choosing a country to launch or with a study, its trends and characteristics? Or maybe you can start from the offer itself. What does this process look like?
The process today is completely different if we compare it 10 years ago. It's just that during the beginning, we started in Netherlands because Mastering Cash and Mediablue is a Dutch company. So at the end, it looks pretty essential why we started in the Netherlands. But today, as I mentioned, we start with the research and the data. Its conclusions that we can make from our data bring us a new opportunity. And we translate these opportunities into offers on different niches and geos.
And what are the main metrics for making such decisions?
We use the Pirates metrics or name R metrics, acquisition, activation, retention, referral, and revenue. In terms of payouts, we work on DOI basis, double opt-in, and RevShare. On each geo, the payouts are different. On RevShare, the average is 38%. On DOI, the difference are pretty big, of for each year, as you can imagine. For example, Switzerland or the Nordics countries have the higher payouts, and the smallest geos like Slovenia, Greece, or Portugal, the payouts are much lower. Or payouts depends on the average spending money for our customers. As much our customers pays in the product, more we can spend on the marketing actions.
And what about activation, retention, resurrection, churn rates? Are they average or high in your business?
In terms of acquisition, for example, the average between SOI and DOI percentage, over time it's 50% in all of the yields, but these metrics are changing every day. But there's minimum differences between yields. In terms of activation, the average is about 3-6% in the overall portfolio of all the countries. But again, it changes between years. Related with retention, as you can imagine, I cannot bring you the figures, but I can inform you that we break down this KPI in three groups: login, chatting, and transaction.
Okay, good choice. And you mentioned that the average rate varies from 3-6%. Does it depend on markets? Are there any differences between markets in this business?
Yes, there's a big difference. For example, in France, the CAC, the cost per customer, is low, for example, but if we compare it with the other years. But the users spend lower money than other years, like Switzerland, for example, where the cost for each customer is new user is expensive, but the user spends much more money than in France. So it's a good example about there's big differences between each year at the end.
Okay, at this stage, I'm already pretty sure you have like big experience about dating and this market. And let's imagine that somebody wants to create a new business in this field, and he or she doesn't have a research that you already had. Is it possible now to start from really from scratch?
It's possible. It's true that this is a vertical that it's mature, it's grown up. So we were working some different companies in this vertical for a long time. But I think that without a proper data, we will make many mistakes and it will cost us a lot of money. So if I will recommend anybody, just if they want to launch a new product or new in any geo at the end, nowadays I don't see the way to invest in any offer or geo without the proper data. So it will be a risky move, but anyway, it's possible. Yes, it's possible. But let me tell you, it will be hard because in other verticals in the affiliation world, you can find there's some new verticals that at the end, there's some space for new partners or new competitors, right? It will be much easier to have to be successful. In this one, it will, without this proper data, it will be hard, let me tell you.
Yeah. And what that newbie person, the beginner in the industry, has to do before the start? What a crucial point.
Yeah, if any company wants to build dating offers, I will recommend you to start
only with only one geo and one vertical. During 1 year where they think they could make the difference and became a good competitor. And afterwards, try to develop new geos and verticals. This is what we did in the Netherlands, for example. And then we started, of course, making mistakes and learning fast, and then preparing better and better and better products and offers. And at the end, we were capable to be more and more profitable for our partners and us as well.
And how much money will it take to make the first offer? How much money do you need to invest in creating this new offer?
This is a pretty hard question to respond, if I'm honest. The cost will depend on the geo that you will pick. If you pick geos like Switzerland or Norway or Finland or Sweden, the test will be much more expensive because of the cost of the marketing actions. If you choose a geo where the population and the cost is balanced, then you can make a much cheaper test. The amount of money to test, it depends on those metrics. Usually with a small test, with a budget of 2K, it will be enough in terms of create a new offer that you will need to design and front up the department to build the offer at the end. It's difficult to say some figures about this process, if I'm honest, because for us, it's much easier because we have a long, long experience. So we have a clear idea. For a new one, it will be much harder, let me tell you.
Yeah, sure. And by the way, have you ever been approached with such a request? Help us create a new offer, for example.
We have many requests like this from people in this market that are focused, for example, in other verticals, but they want to try in this vertical, in dating. So in some cases, they have good proposals and we make business together. But if I'm honest, it's only a few times because at the end, we are one of the most relevant advertisers in the market. We have a pretty good knowledge of the market and this vertical. And at the end, bringing great proposals to make the difference, it's pretty difficult. But we are open every time to discuss these opportunities. Even if in a few cases, we take advantage together with new partners.
Okay, and by the way, what do I need to have in mind to make such an offer to you? Like, I need to have a budget, experience, team, some basics. For example, if I have no budget, no team, no experience, most probably you will not be interested in in cooperation. Am I right?
You're right. You're completely right. At the end, this is what usually happens, you know, that you cover several or different verticals. At the end, it's just that when you talk about one of the main verticals in terms of experience and history, at the end, everything is harder. It's true that we are facing new challenges every day and new changes, but yeah, it's a grown-up project or industry, right? It's pretty different. If you move to other verticals that are new and fresh in the market, the situation is pretty different.
Yeah, sure. And as I know, legal part is a very important part of any business. And for sure, when you make a business for adults, you need to be sure about some points. Make it clear to your audience, to the government, and so on. So let's talk a little bit about this part also. Do you have any issues with this aspect on your platforms, in your products, with your affiliates or customers?
No, we don't. We don't have any legal issues in our products. You can find easily the terms and conditions. And also, you can see that in all of our products, our law only for plus 18 years old people. So it's pretty easy for the users to see that in any page in your product, you can see that this is a product or a service that is only allowed for plus 18 years old people.
And how do you understand that your audience is and your clients is 18 plus years old? How for us, it's
pretty, yeah, for us it's pretty simple.
We inform all of our products that are only allowed for plus 18 years old guys. Our service is adult and we don't allow younger people to sign up. From 18 years old to the other customers, we track the performance of each age group and we take advantage of that information as well.
Yeah, nice choice, nice strategy. And what do you think about future of adult dating in general? What changes the industry can face? What geos can be profitable in the nearest future?
AI will play a very big role, like nearly all the industries. It's everywhere, as we can see. And understanding that dating, it's a matter of conversations. There's a lot of messages that could be automated with AI. Each percentage of messages that AI can present will be a big improvement in your margin. Also, the cooperation between different dating advertisers with X promotion and API will grow more. You need to make the most out of every click. This is the essential of affiliation at the end in our industry. So regarding the geo question, I count on a big success story in Canada with the new platform line, for sure.
Good, good. Very interesting insights. Thank you for them. And let's switch to the team a little bit and to the processes, because if you have a long-term company, you need it to be stable, to forward it from through crises and so on. So you mentioned also earlier that you decided to renew like 60% of your team during this update, creating a new platform. Quite a huge part of the team. And what was the main reason for this? And do you see that your decision was right at this stage?
First of all, yes, it was right. I can see today. We wanted to bring a new energy and new standards to the team. We added great assets with long experience and other ones with great energy to the team. I'm so happy with the new team that we have today. We are ready for the next challenges that we will face. At the end, as you can imagine, in a grown-up company like Mediablue and Mastering in Cash, at the end, there's many people that at the end will join us. A few of them are leaving as well, but we wanted just to improve, keep improving our standards, just to be sure that at the end we can keep bringing the best results to our partners in the market.
And could you tell us a little bit more about your team? Who are they? Where do they locate? What do they do?
Sure. In Mastering Cash, we are 8 people, and in Mediablue, we are around 30 people.
We have different departments: data, product, media buying, affiliation, design, tech, and finance. Our headquarters are based in The Hague, in the Netherlands, and we have people working for us around the world, in Portugal, Japan, Romania, or as me, in Spain. So there's many, many people working around the world.
So you have many of your employees on a remote, and most probably you need a special system to control them. So let's talk about KPIs. Can you share some insights, examples about these processes in your company?
Every year we work with our employees in a personal goal strategy, including what we expect each quarter and what professional and personal growth we expect from them. We bring them the tools to improve each quarter, and each team leader controls each step of the way.
And how do you manage those processes? Is it hierarchical or matrix systems, or perhaps you can set your own in-house solutions for that?
We design our own process with a proper structure and workflow. We develop a process for Mastering Cash and another one for Mediablue. Each company has different needs and requests, and the processes are different as well. In Mediablue, its department has their own leader. We use the OKR model. So it means O, it means objectives, key. K, it means keys, and R means results. So each quarter, each leader presents the projects that we will help to accomplish or goals that are included in our strategy. During the quarter, all the departments involved on each department worked together in a scheduled process in order to provide their part to be sure that we can deliver the project with time enough to test the results and measure the results properly.
Okay, thanks for sharing this with us. And as you mentioned, your team is on remote mostly. Most probably you need to have some kind of ecosystem here. Tools do you use to communicate, to track, or for any other activities inside your business processes?
We use many platforms. We use Teams, Skype, ClickUp, Trello, Miro, and Soho as a CRM system. It's one for different purposes. At the end, we can guarantee that we have all the platforms and the tools to have a quick and fast communication to speed up all the process internally. So even we have a large team in The Hague, and we have another some teammates around the world, we can guarantee that with all of these platforms, we can pretty work in the same way and with a good pace as well.
Nice. Sounds good enough. So we discussed many parts of your business today. And could you remind us what are your main business goals in this year? What are you going to do? The main movements on the market on your side?
At the end, we want to keep bringing added value to the industry as one of the main dating advertisers in the market, as we were doing during the last years. We want to grow with new products, geos, and features that could allow our partners to grow with us to become one of the top dating advertisers in this market. We have some experience in Europe, but we are sure that we can be relevant in other geos as well. So as I mentioned, we will move to North America. We will start with Canada. But let me tell you, there will be very nice and good surprises for the next couple of years.
Okay. It was some bad internet connection. Now we're here again. Finally, it's all we have for you today, Raul. Thank you for such nice insights from your industry, from your team. I hope it will be useful for our audience also. Once again, Raul, thank you very much. Appreciate you found the time to join us. And dear viewers, thanks for being with us today. Watch the other episode of Ads and Grants on the Rich Ads YouTube channel. We have at least 8 interviews with industry top leaders, and we are going to record more in the nearest future, so stay tuned. And feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel below, click the bell icon, and don't miss new videos. Stay tuned for the next video. Bye-bye.